赤く赤く赤く揺れて夢の夢の果て出会ってしまった。運命が回り出す誰も誰も知らない秘密。落ちて落ちて落ちてもう戻れない。罪を刻んでも。
Gamers and gamettes, what is going on? Tanek127 here, and I am hype, baby. I am hype. Ooh, I am hype. You know why? This is Onigiri. Or Onigiri, or I don't know how to say it. All I know is I believe it's a type of anime, and this is an MMO modeled after this anime. Like a Sword Art Online kind of deal. And the best part is it's actually an action RPG MMO. So it's not, you know, turn-based, it's hack and slash MMO. And I'm not talking Ragnarok, Odyssey, Ace, Monster Hunter multiplayer type stuff. I'm talking hack and slash MMO, as you guys will see here. I'm going to give you guys my first impressions on it. Now, keep in mind, it just came out on consoles 3 days ago, so it's going to be laggy, it's going to be buggy, you know, all that stuff. MMOs, they always have rocky launches. If Call of Duty and stuff like that can have a rocky launch, a game that has unlimited players sure as hell can. They added more channels and stuff to the servers, I noticed, after maintenance, so there's a lot more servers now, but the game's just really popular. It's free to play on PlayStation 4, PC, and Xbox One. You guys are going to see how big the PS4 version is here in a minute. I'm hoping there's not a crazy amount of people in the channel that I'm on, but if not, I'll swap, you know, just so you guys can see the gameplay a little bit better. We'll probably go solo a dungeon or something like that, just so I can talk to you guys about the game a bit. And yeah, we're going to go have ourselves some fun. I really do like this game a lot. I enjoy it a whole lot. Okay, yeah, so as you guys can see, the area bit here is a bit heavy. It is pretty laggy right now. Okay, let's get moving here. Go find ourselves a dungeon. Okay, so Onigiri basically is modeled after, I guess, an anime. I've never seen this anime or heard of it, so I wasn't sure. My whole thing is, and I'll be honest with you guys, with Final Fantasy XIV, I had a rough time with it. I've been looking for a decent MMO for a while that's, you know, not as pressuring and something like that. Like, I was waiting for Neverwinter, and then, you know, I noticed people were playing this, and, you know, I just thought it was, you know, some other, you know, Japanese type of Dynasty Warriors type thing. Which I can say, you know, it kind of does look like Dynasty Warriors and plays a bit like it. But I didn't pay any mind. Then I found out it was an MMO, and then people were telling me it was an action RPG MMO, and I'm like hack and slash? And they're like, yeah. And I'm just like, a hack and slash MMO? And they're like, yeah. And I'm just like, how much is it? And they're like, free. And I'm just like, what's the catch? And they're like, nothing. And I'm just like, I go in there, right, and, you know, my Tanek127 account, I haven't even put PlayStation Plus on it yet. I still have my PlayStation Plus on my old Microwave account. And I was even able to download this without PlayStation Plus. Like, I downloaded this under Tanek127, and I'm just like, this is 100% free. Like, free without PlayStation Plus free. And I'm just like, bruh. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it's not the most pretty visuals and all in the world. There's some environmental pop-up, you know, it's still a bit laggy, sketchy, frame rate drops and everything. Like I said, it's a few days after launch, but it's a very good, interesting, fun title. The controls are fairly smooth, they're mapped out really well for console gamers. The tutorial, to my opinion, is lacking a bit on knowledge like that. Like, it doesn't tell you, like, how to party up and all that stuff. You know, you kind of, like, made a character and thrown in there. Like, they're more about teaching you the combat and how to play the game than teaching you about the interface. And that bugged me a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. That was like, eh, whatever. Other than that, the only real gripe I have with this game, besides the server issues, they can make playing it a bit annoying, like when, you know, world bosses and stuff like that show up. World bosses, fates, public events, whatever the hell you call them. I'm used to 14, so I refer to them as world bosses or fates. It can be a bit frustrating to do those just because, you know, the lag and stuff like that from launch. But like I said, if you go up here to where it says system, you go to channel select. These are basically the amount of servers available right now. 5, 6, 7, 8. There was only 6 as of yesterday. And now there's 12. So they've doubled the amount of servers in a night. So, you know, the game's gonna definitely lighten up, and they're managing the servers every day, because apparently the game runs decent on PC from what I know. I was watching a lot of footage, you know, and they had, you know, like big world bosses and everything, and for the most part it was lag and frame rate drop free. But, you know, it has a bit of an in-depth, you know, weapon upgrading system, gear system, and all that stuff. I'm not gonna lie, it's a little bit of a steep learning curve. I haven't got too much into it yet. That's the only reason I'm saying it's steep, because it kind of confuses me a bit. But it's really, really good. We'll go in here and do a dungeon real fast, just so you guys can, you know, get a gist of, like, dungeon play. Parties go up to 5. I haven't done, like, raids and stuff like that. Like I told you, I have done a world boss. You know, there are big events to do with more people, but as far as I've seen it, a light party is composed of 5. I don't know if there's, you know, a full party option. I would guess, you know, if a light party is 5, if there's a full party option, it would be 10 if I started playing the game. So I'm not completely sure. The controls, though, like I said, pretty solid. Movement is a tad bit off. The weapon, you know, attacking controls, pristine, on point. You got, you know, your special moves and stuff like that. Like, lunge step, boom, spirit blast. One shot at that guy, nice. But you'll notice when you, hold on, I'll see you guys here in a second. Another thing I want to talk about is the targeting. That's a little bit sketchy, but I think with some patchwork and stuff that can be fixed easily. The movement, right? You'll notice that I'm running here, and when I stop, he still goes for like 0.1 seconds. It's not a big deal. That's not a make or break for me, but it's just, you know, it makes the controls feel a bit unbalanced. And then, you know, sometimes he stops right away. I think that might just be because of lag, server issues, or whatever. Because, you know, sometimes he stops immediately, and sometimes he'll run for like 0.1 seconds. It's not a make or break thing, but, you know, it's just something there. Let's see. Got your quest list on the side. Earning in-game currency in this game is easy. As you guys can see, I'm a level 18. I'm walking around with 46k right now, and that's just from doing side quests, dungeon farming, and stuff like that. The game is really playable. I mean, there's, you know, ways to buy in-game currency. You know, there is an in-game store, you know, where you can stuff like that, and it's actually pretty cool looking. I'll show that to you guys right now. As a matter of fact, it's actually like modeled, I guess, after the anime and stuff. Okay, I can't use it here, so I'll show you guys that after I do the dungeon. Let's knock these guys out. Sweet, sweet, sweet. One can we blast too? Didn't one shot you. Huh. So far from what I've seen, dungeons are usually composed of a few trash mobs, a mini boss, and some more trash mobs, and the main boss. I haven't seen a dungeon with 3 bosses in it yet. I think the most I've seen is 2. The dungeons aren't crazily long either. Not enough to like stretch out and bore you. I haven't seen anything like, you know, truly menacing. All dungeons have 3 modes: normal, hard, and hell mode. Hell mode is the, you know, the most difficult one, best loot, best XP, blah blah blah. You know, I haven't done a hell mode dungeon yet, so I can't exactly tell you what that's like. But for a free game, a 100% free game, this is pretty damn good. I like it a lot. Like, I like this better than a lot of other MMOs out there. Like, I'm actually enjoying this more than I enjoyed The Elder Scrolls Online, and I was in love with that game. To me, The Elder Scrolls Online, though, didn't really feel too much like an MMO. It felt more like a Skyrim with 1,000 people tossed in it. Let's see. The MMO basic mechanics are in here. You do have healers. You have roles that can work as a tank, but for the most part, everyone's a DPS and healer, pretty much, because every class does massive amounts of damage. Even the healers do massive amounts of damage. I would say for the most part in this game, everyone's a healer and a DPS. Hell, in this game, as fun as it is, I don't even mind healing in here. Look, I'll be honest with you. I'll heal. I don't give a shit. You can even attack with, you know, your wand and stuff like that. Holy crap. Yeah, healers are pretty deadly in here. I did 47 damage. For my level right now, believe it or not, in the gear, I'm wearing this a lot, actually. Because my intelligence isn't high either. Magic says. That's a lot of damage. I'm going to have to look into mage work, actually, now. Because that is surprising. So I'll try not to forget to show you guys the in-game store when I get out of here. A lot of people will think there's no targeting system in here. It's not true. It is a bit off, I'm not gonna lie. The targeting does need work. You will push on a PlayStation 4, you will push triangle to target, it'll lock you on like that. Your character will focus on the enemy, but I notice you'll still miss a lot. Which is weird, so I think, you know, the targeting still need work. Then again, that, you know, it could be just, you know, in-game bug and lag issues. I'm not sure. I've never played the PC version. I've never played this game. I've been having a bunch of patches and upgrades to it. What it's like. I don't know. I like this game. I like this game a lot. I don't know it enough to give it a rating yet, so I'm just definitely going to leave this, like, as a first impressions kind of deal. Heal up some. See, they made this game completely console friendly, and I love when MMO companies do that. Like when Square Enix did it with 14, how that game runs on console is amazing, even on PlayStation 3. How this is, how ESO was, you know, I really like the DC Universe and all of them. I'm not gonna lie, some of the music in here is can be corny, but a lot of it's pretty catchy too. I do like some of the music in here, actually. Come on, give up now. You're not good. I don't care how many enemies you get. I'm gonna blow them all away. Is that real? Give me that show off. 7 minutes, not bad. Alright. Now before we wrap this up, I just want to show you guys the in-game store, how interactive it is, how cool it is, how like anime-ish and everything it looks. Let's get out here to the open world. Over here, click the shop. Shopping Plaza. I'm gonna use that here. What the hell? So where can you use it? Alright. We're gonna run back to that basic town, see if we can use it there. Another thing I'm curious to know is if there's like mounts and stuff in here. I mean, it's an MMO, I'm sure there are mounts. Leveling in here, I'm not sure what the level cap and stuff is, but the leveling in here actually isn't bad at all. It's I've been growing pretty easily so far. The highest I've seen anyone walk around is 44. And I don't think that's the end. See, you got a bit of environmental pop-up and all just from like glitching and stuff like that. But the highest I've seen anyone so far is like 44, 45. So I'm gonna guess it's, you know, starting at 50 like any traditional MMOs, then when, you know, patches and expansion comes, it'll probably raise by like 5 or 10 every expansion, blah blah blah, usual stuff. Now let's see if we can use it here. There we go. Yeah, this is the in-game store. I thought this was really cool and interactive. Like, it actually has like a shopping cart. It's integrated with PlayStation Network. It's really, really cool. This I liked. I thought this was really creative. It's stupid, I know. You know, why are you promoting, you know, microtransactions and DLC and blah blah blah? I'm just saying, this is freaking creative, man. And they actually got, you know, some pretty cool stuff in here. Like I told you guys, I'm a punk rock goth kind of guy myself, so the fact that, you know, they got a lot of Japanese goth stuff in here is awesome to me. Awesome. Any anime fan, you know, that plays MMOs and stuff like that, if you're like one of those guys who, you know, like to do nothing but watch Dragon Ball Z and Bleach and play MMOs all day, please download this. Because it definitely fits in with you. That's kind of my lifestyle. This is basically your main central area for the starter players. See, there's lots of people here. It's getting laggy. There's actually a lot more than what you see standing there, which is why it's acting so crazy. Like, I'll probably go and talk to one of these guys, and then like, you see how I'll do that continuous running thing over here? I think that's honestly just because of in-game bugs and lag. But it's just because the game's new, they still haven't perfected the servers yet. As you guys can see, there's a lot of wild stuff, you know, going on. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Onigiri is a really fun, great hack and slash MMO. I do like the concept going here. I can't wait to dive more into the storyline, learn more about the lore and stuff like that. I really enjoy playing this. I will be playing it a lot, but keep in mind it is 100% free to play on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC. I hope you guys enjoyed. A special shout out to Onigiri US on Twitter for speaking of them, their Twitter page is really good, very responsive. Every single question I asked them yesterday was answered within 10 or 20 minutes. They responded to everybody that could. Their Twitter feed was just filled with responses. They're doing everything they can, you know, to keep people updated and stuff on the game, answer all your questions. Every stupid in-game question I had, they answered. So there's a lot of support behind this game. I really like it, and I really, you know, do appreciate that they do that. So big shout out to Onigiri US at Twitter. And I'll definitely tag them in this video. Special shout out to them. And guys, honestly, if you're an MMO player, give the game a shot. I don't think you'll be disappointed. If you can get over to, you know, the launch day bugs and all that stuff, it's definitely a good game to play. But thank you guys so much for watching. It's your boy, Tenek127. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Peace, guys.